All right, welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Chef Cam, Chef Cam just showed us some creative lunchbox ideas for kids heading back to school. Yeah. Now we'll show the high school and college kids some love with a few social media do's and don'ts. Mm-hmm. And here to break it all down is professor, businesswoman, agent, good friend, and a tell it like it is sister, Selena's big sister, Dr. Syleecia. Yes, we love having you down here,
Doc. I'm just back down to the circle. I'm so excited. Like, I don't know what to do.
Well, you know what to do. You got to tell us about these do's and don'ts. Well, we'll get into that in just a second. But how long have you been a professor?
Well, you guys know I'm an agent, brand strategist, but I've been a full-time professor. I teach at Berklee College, and I've been teaching for 17 years.
How about that?
I was five when I started.
Clearly.
I'm so sorry, because how old are you? 22.
Wow.
But I thought it was appropriate because we're in the back-to-school mode, and I know the social media thing is a big thing. Everybody's lit this summer, turning up, but, you know, that's why I wanted to kind of talk about social media.
Yes, because even the people need to know how to use it, and even the college kids. I know you see it firsthand.
Yeah, I do, and I tell my students, I've said, what you post online is going to follow you forever, bro.
Right, that's true.
It's going to follow you because there are programs out there called the dark web.
Okay.
So your pictures and your tweets and all of that stuff goes into the web, and it could follow you later in life and mess you up as a potential candidate.
So if someone posts something and they delete it, like, if I delete something off my Instagram, it's still
in
the dark web somewhere.
It's in the web.
Down
it's in
to
the
dark
web.
And that goes for tweets, too.
Yes.
That's an Insta story now. They could take picture, screenshot your Insta story and take that and put it in there.
Yes. And here's the thing. 65% of employers check social media to see how candidates present themselves.
That is true.
65%.
Okay, so that's a lot. So how often should students post, though?
Well, I mean, I think for social media, it's for four reasons, right? To either empower, to educate people, to entertain people, or to enhance other people's lives, right? So I came up with some do's and don'ts.
All right.
And let's get into these do's.
Okay.
The first do is to think before you post. Because of the dark web,
that's true.
Whatever you post is going to show up later, okay, in life.
You have to look at it like that. You have to kind of go into it thinking, this could get out somewhere.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And my second one, I love this one. Be authentic with a censor. So sometimes keeping it real is keeping it real stupid.
Yeah. Right.
And you have to be opinionated, but with a purpose.
Yes.
Because you don't have to attend every argument down to the Instagram that you're invited to.
Yes.
So, but we don't want students and young people to lose their voice. So be opinionated with a purpose.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I like that.
Because it's too much. We don't want them to lose themselves. So the second do, the third do. Share, post, engage. And I've got some good examples of people that have been doing great on social media. I think you guys got that graphic. It's Calman Stokes and Lewis McNary. They use their pages beautifully. Lewis McNary, former student of mine. And then the last do is network and build relationships. So those are my do's.
That's Calman. Wow.
He's doing his thing.
Yes.
He's
a model.
It's crazy. Talk to my kids that are in my sporty girls, I always say, when you think about your posts, is it appropriate for your future children to see?
Right.
I give that.
Which brings me to my point, my don't. The first don't is don't be Kim Kardashian.
Oh,
no shade.
Well, a little tree came out.
What I mean is, no shade. But what I mean is, Kim Kardashian has spent years building her brand, right? So she's a multimillionaire. She could be naked. She could be posting whatever down to the Instagram.
Right.
You can't. So you can't get caught up into what
she does.
Celebrities are doing.
Yeah.
The second one is don't use crazy names and handles. That creates brand confusion.
Yeah, it does.
So if you got like a whole bunch of different names. Now what if, you have you John on the Insta down to the Instagram, but then you try to go down to the Twitter and be John, but then it's taken. So then you're John 123, and then down to the Facebook, you're John 456, because it was taken on the other two.
I brought some good examples. One of my students, I love her to death. Her name is beautiful, Kalijah.
Ooh.
First of all,
down to the Instagram, her name is Henny Mix. She likes the mix.
She like Hennessy then.
Okay. She's got a move. And the Chocolate Hennessy. Princess. Birkin girl.
Well, how do people go find you for real?
Have a Birkin bag? I don't know. And then Mississippi Lou. His name is Antonio Thompson.
He's from Mississippi?
No. He's from actually Chicago.
Oh, my God.
So my next don't is don't post a million times per day, right? So you look desperate. And shouldn't you be studying young kids? Okay.
Yeah.
What if they're posting their accolades of getting A's and B's.
Yeah.
We need to see the receipts.
Right.
Because I've never seen somebody else's A's and B's.
I never see a report card on Twitter.
Mm-hmm. So, have you?
I have not. Somebody's mama posted a report card
before, but I do have a question about adults. I know this is about students, but real quickly, as an adult, how often should you be posting?
There's rules. So Facebook, they allow you about 4 to 5 times per week. Twitter, you can do 5 to 6 times a day. But Instagram is brilliant because you can use Instagram story to get your messages out, and it goes away in 24 hours.
Okay. Yeah. Instagram
Instagram, you got to be careful, but the algorithms are all messed up now. Mm-hmm. So you just want to be mindful. Mm-hmm. You know, it affects your personal brand.
Now, what about the time of day? Is it important? What are the best times of day to post, effective as a business person?
Well, people hire me to tell that question. So you can go to my website and book me. There are times. Certain times of the day, people are at work. In the evening, there's certain times of the day. We just don't have the time to go here. Plus,
You can do the insight, actually, on Instagram, and it tells you when your peak times are. So that's really, really good. I think you should take an opportunity to take advantage of that. Mm-hmm. You just go there. You can see, actually, how many people are following. All of the demographics are right there.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to be a business.
You do.
Yes. What about Snapchat? Is that important?
But here's it. Snapchat is for the younger generation. Mm-hmm. But I think this last one, I got to get in. Don't use privacy settings.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You look secretive and weird. So, what are you hiding?
Yeah.
Got it.
Well,
especially if you're a business.
Yes, absolutely. Well, Dr. Syleecia, we always love having you down to. And you're looking real good, Dr.
The Circle. Please follow her on social media and check out her website, drsyleecia.com. Let's give it up for Dr. Syleecia.